Now, as Dr. Zelig says, the ABCs can be used intentionally to change behavior. But we should also be aware that the ABCs occur in our natural environment. For example, let's say you're thirsty. This is a motivation. Then you see the refrigerator, which is the cue. Then you grab a soda and drink it, which is the behavior. Then your thirst is quenched, and you had something tasty to drink, which is the consequence. Because the consequence was positive, this tells me that I'm more likely to go to the refrigerator and get a drink when I'm thirsty. However, there's another way we can look at this. Let's take the same scenario. First, say you're thirsty, which is your motivation. You see the refrigerator, which is your cue. So the behavior in this scenario is that you grab milk and drink it, but it was sour milk. So the consequence in this scenario is that you spit out the milk and it was really gross. It didn't quench your thirst. So this is a negative consequence. Therefore, you're going to be less likely to go back to the refrigerator and grab milk in the future.